My technology is, in scientific terms, what we call a multiplex detection test. It detects anywhere between 3 to 7 infectious diseases at the same time and distinguishes them within about 10 to 40 minutes, at most within an hour. You will note that several diseases that are occurring in our African and other regions have similar symptoms like high fever, vomiting, headache, and it becomes confusing, you know, for a doctor to tell exactly what infection is causing the disease. So my test, which is now called a Nyan-test, can perform the detection and then distinguish and pinpoint the infection that is causing the disease.
All right, 10 to 14 minutes is quite something different compared to other testing methods, but apart from time-wise, what other differences are we looking at that this innovation is coming up with?
Right. You will note that machines that are used contemporarily for certain diagnostics are very bulky, they're very huge, big, and they take a very long time to perform these diagnostics. Also, they are very expensive for our regions. And so in comparison to that, my system of detection is affordable as compared to the contemporary and ones we have. It takes a shorter time as compared to the contemporary ones that are used to diagnose. And it is very portable, that it can be taken into hard to reach areas, like, you know, rural areas, villages. One of the good features of the system that we have is that you can use it in a car, using a car lighter if there's no electricity. And we are looking at putting a solar option on our system. So these characteristics distinguish our system from that of the systems that are on the market.
How far are you with the implementation of this particular innovation of yours?
We have completed the building and development of our first version. And this first version was tested in 3 pilot clinical studies. These studies were performed by me and my team, my assistant, at the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. And they were very successful. These results were and data were validated and published. One of our data were published in Nature Scientific Reports. One was published in International Journal of Clinical Diseases. So the information and the characteristics and quality of our system is within the scientific community already. Feedback that we have got during discussions with other scientists and clinicians have been very positive. And during these exhibitions, doctors who pass by and listen to the work that we are doing and see how the system, you know, operates, have also, I would say, demanded that we immediately have it available. And so feedback has been fine. We are now going towards producing the second version, and we are in process of producing that. Once we produce the second version, which is our second generation prototype, which will be far more superb than what we have now, we will then go for field trial. And we intend to try it in Liberia, Sierra Leone, and we have a field trial site in Ecuador. We hope also that we can have a field trial site in the southern part of Africa and Central Africa. So we are looking at Rwanda and South Africa. Once we get those data, then we'll be ready for production and begin to go through regulatory agencies.
Interesting. There is high prevalence of infectious diseases on the continent, such as HIV, and we are seeing outbreaks of Ebola in different parts of the continent. So how exactly is this particular system going to contribute? How is it, how significantly will it contribute in terms of prevention or maybe responding to these diseases?
Yes, and this is one of the important factors that, you know, led to this ingenuity, or that propelled this ingenuity in coming up with this detection method. Just as you rightly said, and we spoke about that, you have these complex of diseases that are all over Africa and in some parts of the world. Here, for example, you have the Ebola crisis, which just cropped up in the DRC, and you have neighboring countries here. We have malaria, we have yellow fever, Lassa fever. All of these diseases have pretty much the same onset clinical symptoms. So with this detection method, it's going to contribute in the aspect of making definitive diagnosis so that patients are then given the exact medications that are required. Secondly, with the availability of our detection system, we're also going to see a situation whereby it can be used for consistent monitoring and surveillance, epidemiological surveillance. And in that sense, before an infection breaks out into an epidemic, it will be caught immediately and arrested. So we intend that our system will be put, you know, placed at border checkpoints, designated areas at border crossings, because you have movement of people, and through the movement of people, you have movement of diseases also. It will be used in the clinics, it will be used in military hospitals, research hospitals, and other areas that you have populated people.
So with such innovations coming up, can we expect to see maybe more sophisticated innovations that not only do detection but also treatment, for example?
Well, for now, we are really concentrating on what we know best, and we are focusing our attention in that niche. And in order to improve our system, develop a better version of it every time, and then create a home-based system as well in the future. Because of the infectious nature of what we're dealing with, we're restricting ourselves presently to just it being stationed in hospitals. But yes, the good thing is that with our system, it's going to help doctors to know exactly then which treatment to give, because they will then be armed with the information of the diseases that they will be treating.